Welcome back. We're approaching the close of a long Sunday, a Super Sunday or a Saffron Sunday. But what are the big takeaways on this dramatic day, an intriguing day in Indian politics after the results in Maharashtra and Haryana? Joining us now, Yogendra Yadav of the Aam Aadmi Party, who's been campaigning for the party in the past in Haryana. They didn't even contest there this time. Also joining me is Asauddin Owaisi, who is of the Majlis-e-MIM, which has won 3 seats in Maharashtra. Only 1 to the MNS, 3 to the MIM. And Jai Narayan Vyas of the BJP. But I want to come to you, Yogendra Yadav, first, because you can give us a sense of those big takeaways. The question I'm raising, what are the big takeaways you see at the end of this long day in Indian politics? If I were to ask you 3 things that you believe have changed as a result of October 19, 2014.
First, in the short term, it has led to a shift of balance of power in favor of the ruling coalition. Within the ruling coalition, in favor of the BJP. Within the BJP, in favor of Mr. Modi and Shah combined. In the medium run, it would lead to electoral realignment in such a way that BJP is becoming more of an All India party, and parties like Congress are shrinking. And today, 2 more states may have shrunk to a level where it would be very difficult for the Congress to bounce back. So Congress is shrinking. Third, in the long run, in the country, political options are becoming more limited. While BJP is succeeding, it is succeeding precisely by replicating the Congress formula. We see more of a congressization of the BJP, which is to say that in the country, serious political options are shrinking. There is not just a vacuum of opposition. We are dealing with a serious political vacuum in the country.
You know, just that last point, on the other hand, the flip side would be that the BJP has thrown up a credible, strong regional leader, Shivraj Singh Chauhan, Raman Singh, good examples, and they are playing the Narendra Modi card, and the combination is a deadly one. A strong national leader and credible state leaders are giving the BJP an edge. I know it didn't happen in Haryana where they didn't have a strong state leadership, but in Maharashtra also they are throwing up younger leaders. Are you getting the sense that the BJP today is more hungry and attuned to elections than the Congress party? Earlier in the program, someone suggested that Congress has become geriatric.
Of course, that's true, Rajdeep. BJP is more dynamic. It has more of a vision. It ran its campaign in a more energetic way. It is pumping in more resources. It is more organized. All this is completely true. But at the end of it, you also want to ask the question of what it means for the country. In the last instance, you and I watched the game of politics, not because we happen to... This happens to be a, you know, cricket match. In the last instance, this game has something to do with the fate of the people. So you want to ask the question of what does it mean for the people? And that's why I made the last point.
Okay. Well, you believe that there are still questions over lack of political option. Well, the fact is the Aam Aadmi Party, Yogendra Yadav, didn't even contest in Haryana. And very quickly, do you believe that was a big mistake in hindsight, given that there was this strong anti-Hooda mood which has been captured by the BJP? Did the Aam Aadmi make a big mistake by not even trying to contest in Haryana?
No, Rajdeep. Look, for no political party, not contesting an election can be the first or the most pleasant option. We wanted it. We debated it. There was free and frank discussion in the party. At the end of it, at the national level, we took a consensus decision, which is that before Delhi Assembly election, we do not want to contest any other state, a general election any other state. Because for us, coming back to Delhi, reviving there is our first priority. I think that's a decision whose wisdom can be judged only after we have had Delhi election.
Well, all I can say is that the high command culture seems to have got into the Aam Aadmi Party as well, where these decisions are taken in the manner that they are. But Yogendra Yadav, appreciate your joining us. I know you have to go off to Aaj Tak, so thanks very much for joining us. Let me then turn to you, Asauddin Owaisi, because you're an interesting phenomenon in the Maharashtra elections. You won 3 seats. Am I to understand that the MIM has now decided that you are now going to be the party of the Muslim community, not just in Hyderabad, the old city, but in other parts as well? You are going to play, in a sense, the role of a party which will go into all constituencies where there is a large Muslim population. Mr. Owesi.
Rajdeep, I beg to differ with you because if you because if you see the constituencies from where we have won, these are not a completely a Muslim majority constituencies. And secondly, yes, there is a scope, and what is wrong if the minorities have more participation, more representation in a parliamentary democracy? This is very good for a vibrant parliamentary democracy. This will create more confidence.
Let me put 2 points to you very clearly. First, out of the three candidates, sir, out of the three candidates, one is Arun Gowli's daughter. Arun Gowli was a gangster. His daughter is one of your seats. A former journalist has won from Aurangabad, which has a large Muslim population. So clearly you are targeting the minority vote. You are playing a very limited politics, and thereby you are dividing the so-called secular vote even further and trying to play the politics of claiming that you are the party of Muslim grievance. And you are now going to try and do that across India. Is that a wise step, you believe? Are you playing that kind of role now to claim that you represent Muslim interests?
Rajdeep, please understand that your research team has not told you that we have contested only 24 seats.
Yes.
Now, are you trying to say that the remaining 260 odd seats are communal seats? And in the last Lok Sabha elections and in 2009, not a single Muslim got elected from Maharashtra. From 62 to 2009, 600 MPs have been elected, and what is the minority share? It's only 14. And if I am playing a role which asks for political empowerment, why do you suspect my motives?
Because your critics will say, Asauddin, that what you call political empowerment, the secular critics will say you are dividing the secular vote, and your critics on the other side will say that Asauddin is playing communal politics, that you are appealing only to one segment of Indian society.
One segment, I have not asked people to vote and in the name of religion. The Hindutva judgment of Supreme Court is very clear. We have not violated the model code of conduct. And these so-called secular parties, can they please tell us what is wrong with them? That why haven't they elected? How many members have Congress given? How many Muslim members have NCP given? And what is the share of Muslim representation in the parliament everywhere? What is the socio-economic indicators in Maharashtra for God's sake, in last 15 years, it has gone from bad to worse. I would have loved to take on the ex-chief minister Prithviraj Chauhan when he talks so proudly. Why did they break their alliance? I mean, who stopped them from continuing with their alliance, and who stopped them from doing, uplifting the education parameters or the socio-economic conditions of Muslims of Maharashtra?
Asauddin Owesi, I can see where you're coming from, but what it does mean, therefore, is the MIM has now decided, perhaps for the first time, and I think, correct me if I'm wrong, this is the first time you have won seats outside Hyderabad. So given that, first time you won outside Andhra Pradesh, certainly. So clearly you are aiming now to become a party. Tomorrow you may go to Assam. You may go to other parts with large Muslim populations. Am I correct that you will now aim to go to all parts of the country with large Muslim populations?
Definitely, I'll be going to Uttar Pradesh. I'll be going to West Bengal. Why not? This is, in a parliamentary democracy, if I go to Uttar Pradesh, if I go to West Bengal, if I contest in Karnataka, what is wrong in that?
You have every right.
What is wrong in that?
Sir, you have every right.
Sir,
you have every right. You have every right. I'm only worried about the message. You have every right to contest.
Please allow me to. Rajdeep, don't worry about the message. Okay. Don't worry about the message. We will be creating more confidence in the minority community, in the parliamentary democracy. And you need not worry. We will be not attacking journalists as other people have done.
Okay, let's leave it at that. Asauddin Owesi.
There's one little point I want to make.
Yes, yes.
That the party has always been known as the All India Majlis Ittehad al-Muslimin.
I know. So AIMIM, but this is the first time that they have got a breakthrough outside Hyderabad,
where they've succeeded.
Yeah. Point taken.
So they've never said that we are a party confined to Hyderabad. they have always had an All India character, which is now manifesting itself.
I take your point. And one of the ironies of this election is MIM wins three seats and MNS, which claims to stand for the Marathi Manus, wins one. So maybe Raj Thackeray needs to introspect.
Why, Mr. Owaisi intends to launch. Irony?
Yes.
No, Rajdeep, you have a very soft corner for Raj Thackeray. Come on, don't compare me with him.
Okay, we will talk about that on another day. We'll put Asauddin Owaisi and Raj Thackeray next to each other. But let me take a break. Thank you very much, Mr. Owaisi, for joining us on the program. When I return, Jai Narayan Vyas, who's been holding on to the other big question that I want to raise. The Amit Shah formula. Does Amit Shah have some magic formula to win elections? That's the next big question that we will raise with someone who has been back. The last big question that we are posing today on what's been a long day is, who is the man of the match? We always choose on election day a man of the match. And is this man, Amit Shah, the man of the match, the master strategist? Yes, Narendra Modi, the brand ambassador, the campaigner, but the brain, was it Amit Shah? Is this now Jodi number one? Amit Shah and Narendra Modi when it comes to election. Jai Narayan Vyas, who served in the cabinet with Narendra Modi and Amit Shah, is Amit Shah someone who understands how to fight elections? An election strategist, he was the one who pushed the BJP, we are told, to break the alliance with Shiv Sena. He's the one who masterminded this non-Jat Dalit alliance also in Haryana. Is he a master election strategist?
Well, Rajdeep, I'll qualify my sentence and reply saying that other things remaining constant. I would compare or draw a simile from the Second World War successful generals who, in a similar condition, could enthuse their armies. Their very presence was a sign of confidence. They never took the defeat as acceptable, and they put in their best to plan the strategy so that the enemy was caught unawares. And I would specifically quote General Patton, who said that no bloody bastard can win the war by dying for his country. A bloody bastard can win the war only by making others to die for his country. I think this is precisely my assessment of Amit Shah's psyche and personality. He understands the nitty-gritties of election. He understands the nitty-gritties and profile of voters. He is a master strategist.
Okay.
And having now a very successful past at his back, from Uttar Pradesh now to Maharashtra and Haryana, I think his very presence imbibed confidence and enthusiasm in rank, file and cadre of our workers. So I think sum total of it
is that
he has emerged today as somebody.
You know, I take your point. When you're on a roll, you're on a roll. You're now likening him to General Patton. But quick, you know, I just have 10 seconds. Look at how the world has changed. 18 months ago, Amit Shah was possibly facing an extended jail sentence in a fake encounter case. Today, he's become the man of the match in this election. Do you believe, Surjit Bhalla, somewhere, that Amit Shah has understood how elections are to be fought? That he has understood the changing voter? He's understood, you know, how to use Narendra Modi in an election campaign, and he's galvanized the organizational machine of the BJP, particularly at the local level, using the RSS karyakartas very effectively.
In order for him to be the man of the match, you have to ask the counterfactual. What would have happened if Narendra Modi was not the candidate?
So you're saying Amit Shah needs a Narendra Modi to go out there and play this strategy.
Yeah.
He could
so
not have
say,
done this without Narendra Modi.
Absolutely. So I think the real man of the match in the Lok Sabha election as well as now is Narendra Modi. That's not to take away anything from strategy, etc. But no strategy would have worked unless you had a candidate like Narendra Modi.
Okay, we've had two men of the match here in our studios who bravely sat next to each other through the day. Manishankar Iyer, Seshadri Chari. Appreciate your joining us. It's been wonderful having you through all the highs and lows of the day. And let me also salute another man of the match, because Dhananjay Joshi has done the seemingly impossible. In a five-cornered race, you got it bang on 100%. So Dhananjay Joshi, Amit Shah and Narendra Modi are possibly the three men of the match who are going to share the trophy at the end of this long election day. And you, the viewer, and you, the voter, who always surprises us and leaves elections for us as a great experience to share with you on television. And the wonderful backroom team here at the TV Today Network who've organized this show. I only wish the Election Commission would choose any other day than a Sunday next time to have an election. I'm afraid I missed my Sunday Malish today, but my Malishwala, who's from Haryana, got the elections right in his home state. Thank you all very much for joining us. Goodbye, good night, have a safe night.